Hi! In this video, we're going to take a closer look at the rental asset complexity. I am Johannes, and this is Learn with LootLocker. An understanding of assets, characters, classes, and complexities are needed to follow along in this video. So if you haven't watched those videos, I recommend that you do that now. Link is in the description. The rental complexity has a lot of use cases. It is an asset that, when activated, will be removed after a set amount of time. So it can be used for a lot of things. A cooldown for abilities, consumable items, and much more. A rental asset can contain other assets, so the setup can be made very complex if your game needs it. I'm now going to show you a way to implement it in a game. In my example, I use the rental asset to activate a booster, and when that booster is activated, a particle system will play for the same duration as the rental asset. So in this example, I'm using it as a consumable booster that the player can use. A rental asset has to be activated, it cannot be equipped. So if your rental asset contains assets, you need to first activate the rental asset and then equip the items that you get in return from the response if you want the player to equip it directly. Now, let's take a look at how a rental asset is set up on the LootLocker dashboard. When you want to create a rental asset, you first need to create a rental context. So we head to Settings, Context, and click Add Context. Give it a name, change the complexity to Rental Asset, and select which character classes that can use it. For demonstration purposes, I will make this available to all my characters by selecting all classes. Next, we head to Content, Assets, and create a new asset with a new rental complexity context that we just made. Now we have two new tabs, Rental Content and Rental Tiers. In the Rental Content tab, we can add assets that will be added to the player's inventory during the time that the rental asset is active. An example would be to gift the player a special sword for 1 minute. But you can also leave this blank if you want to do something custom in your game during the time the booster is active. The next tab, Rental Tiers, allows you to set up several durations on the same asset. So if you, for example, have an XP boost in your game, there might be different levels to it. So by adding different tiers to one asset, you only need to create one, instead of having several with the same information. Alright, let's dive into Unity and look at how this can be implemented. When we get the player's inventory with the getInventory function, LootLocker will return information for all the assets inside of the player's inventory. When we've gotten this response, I run a check to see if it is a rental asset and if it has been consumed. And we can do this by checking the rental.timeLeft property on the asset. If the time left is below 0 or 0, that means that the rental asset is no longer active and should not be shown inside of the player's inventory. If the time left isn't up, we will show it in the player's inventory with the function handleItem. In my implementation, I run this useItem function when an asset is clicked in the inventory, which will check if the item can be equipped. Now we check if it is a rental asset, and in that case we will activate it by running LootLocker SDK Manager.activating a rental asset, and send in the asset instance ID that we got from the previous response. We have now activated the rental asset on the server, meaning that it will be removed from the player's inventory after the duration. So I start a timer that has the same duration as the rental asset and display a particle effect during this time. And when the duration is up, the particle effect is destroyed. It can be good to keep in mind that if the player quits or pauses your game in the middle of an active rental, the timer on the server is not stopped. You will need to ask the server again for the remaining time left on the rental asset to keep it in sync. And that is all there is to rental assets. Rental assets are a simple and easy way to create consumable items in your game, either as time boosters or temporary buffs or debuffs for your game. If you enjoyed this video, please leave a like, and to not miss out on any new content, make sure to subscribe. Alright, thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.